Okay, we got newspaper articles as usual. Chicago Tribune, December the 8th. Seas present threat to historic cities. Climate-related flooding poses existential crisis. And this is out of North Carolina, Swansboro. Okay? And you can take a look here. You see that, don't you? Okay? In deep water, right? A truck maneuvers up a flooded street in Charleston, South Carolina. Coastal southeast cities are grappling with rising sea levels. So, again, though the Babylon is sinking. You remember chapter 51, huh? The back end of the chapter. It says, historic cities and towns along the southeastern U.S. coast have survived wars, hurricanes, disease outbreaks, and other calamities, but now that sea levels are creeping up with no sign of stopping. They face a more existential crisis, okay? With a total annual budget of $225 million, Charleston, South Carolina can't afford the billions of dollars to save itself without federal help. It's counting on the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to help surround its downtown peninsula with seawalls hearkening to the barriers the city built when it was founded 350 years ago. All right, so you know that's not going to happen. Because the government is broke. Okay, I looked at the article the other day. They can't even, the Navy can't get the money they want to build the different warships they want to build. You understand what I'm saying? Okay? It's broke. It's bad boy. It's collapsing right before our eyes. And nothing going to save America. As y'all said, trouble going to rise. They going to know from where it rises because it's rising from everywhere. Now, you follow what I'm saying? These people running around, you know, with their Xmas and Thanksgiving and New Year's and all this Easter and all this nonsense, 4th of July and birthdays, a bunch of nonsense, huh? Can't see for looking. Got eyes open and can't see a thing. You understand? Steeped in their idolatries. See? And again, they running around more now, huh? Because of the homelessness, the economic collapse. And this dollar is collapsing right before their eyes, as we've been talking about for years here, y'all, right? And many of these economists, as I said, right? They see what's going on. You follow what I'm saying? Now, you understand? They need what? Billions of dollars to try to build some walls around Charleston, South Carolina. Now, it ain't happening, okay? Bad boy is sinking, just like Yah said it would. That's the prophecy. But these people know not the prophecies of Yah. Know not the thoughts of Yah, right? Okay? Also, I wrote in here when I heard this, you understand, this 5G technology is spreading radioactivity. They got these towers set up, look like cactuses. Some of these, you know, the people I was driving, they think it's a cactus, it's a cell tower. Okay, look like palm trees. They have them disguised. You probably could tell palm trees. It's a tower. Okay, and this radioactivity, this 5G is powerful. Okay, and these people carrying around these smartphones that they paying $600, $700, $800, $400, $500, $1,000 for $1,500. They think that your head's down. They don't even see what's going around them because they. Eyes is glued to that screen on that smartphone, and they carrying around, huh, radioactivity in their hand, just like I see them with their, you know, piece on their ear. You follow me? And like I did years ago, I talked about it some years ago. This brother I saw here about 7 years ago, he had that thing on his ear. I was out at, you know, at this picnic, and I mentioned to him, I said, yeah, brother, he said, you know, you can get radioactive. What? Huh? He didn't want, you know. I said, oh, okay. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, when you turn the light on, you shake them. Hey, what you shake me? Don't wake me up. You know, turn that light off. Let me go back to sleep and let this radioactivity, you know, you understand, just bombard me. You follow me? But this 5G technology, that stuff is strong. With radioactivity, it's, you know, sending off. If you had a Geiger counter needle would probably jump, you understand, up into the red. You follow me? Also, I got here, you understand, it's about $470 trillion that have been printed, you understand, in this economy in 1 month. Okay? Matter of fact, I got you, it's really big. They printed up $470 billion in 1 month. From the middle of November to the middle of December, and inseminated into the economy. You know, this body, you understand? It's like a body on the table that the faint heartbeat, and they shooting it with electric shock and you know, what's that? Some kind of solution they inject into them, trying to get the heart ticking. Well, that's what they doing with this, you know, this Federal Reserve note. Printing paper. See, that's why these nations now don't want it. Yeah, we don't want that. See, that's why these nations stocking up on gold and silver. You follow what I'm saying? On some kind of commodity, you follow me, that's not going to lose its value. Because they don't want none of this worthless paper. All these fiat currencies are collapsing as I speak. And it's becoming more and more apparent now. You follow me? Okay, but you don't hear anything about that on CBS, ABC, NBC, CNBC, you know what I mean? You don't hear anything about that. Fox, they don't talk about any of that news. See, that's what I was talking about earlier, right? You understand? Also, the Sacklers, you know, the Edomite family that, you understand, came up with Oxycontin, right? You understand? Say they selling the antidote now. Okay? They come up with the drug, you know, filled with the opium, and disseminate that out and make billions of dollars with that, getting people addicted to the opioids, right? Now they come out with the antidote and they selling that. Okay? You follow me? You understand? They selling the antidote for $30 a tab. Okay? So they gonna make money coming and going. You follow me? Nah. Okay? And they say over in China, they selling it for $30 a tab. Here, they sell it for $50 a tab over in China. Nah. Okay? And also, let me just read this because I had this marked on this I tell you, boy. On this, you know, flooding right down in Charleston. It said, Charleston, with state and federal help, is spending $64 million to raise the lowest part of the seawall guarding its downtown battery, which should keep that part of the city safe, even if the ocean rises more than 6 feet in the next century. Okay, say the city also is spending hundreds of millions of dollars to modernize its stormwater system. Said, but these measures alone probably can't save a city that was once the most heavily fortified in North America, with a system of walls, moats, drawbridges to keep out the Spanish, French, Native Americans, and occasionally the ocean as well. The city's 7 million visitors each year come looking for old charm along the water, but probably not underfoot. Okay, downpours regularly cause flooding these days, and more than once a week on average. You hear that? Flooding more than once a week. Charleston gets sunny day flooding when tides push water onto city streets. Even when the sun is shining, it floods. All right? Oh, boy. Say, four of the 7 highest water levels recorded in Charleston Harbor have happened in the past 4 years. Pushed by Hurricane Matthew in 2016, Hurricane Irma in 2017, and nor'easters type storms that hit in 2015 and 2018. Now, it's a big article, but I just read the significant part. Now, that's what's going on. You follow me? You don't hear anything about that on these news when you listen to it, though, do you? Huh? Chicago Tribune, December the 8th. North Korea says denuclearization no longer on the negotiating table. Because that Kim Jong-un said, I ain't no fool. You understand? We got these nuclear weapons. That's the only reason you want to talk. You understand what I mean? We not denuclearizing. So you forget that. That's off the table. Right? And they just started some more tests here. Okay? You follow me? So what Trump talking about? Huh? Third day of protest clashes grips France amid travel woes. Huh? An anti-riot police officer fends off protesters during a demonstration against pension reform. You hear that? That's coming here. I mean, you understand? Because they can't keep these pensions going. That's coming here. What you see going on in France, I mean, they've been protesting in France, you know, them yellow vestas, right? Now, Macron came up with some pension reform early last month, and that just put fuel to the fire. These Frenchmen is upset because they see what? You understand? They can't maintain the lifestyle that they had. And so now they protesting even more. Okay, and the riot police, we saw this yesterday. Riot police shooting tear gas and then killed so many of these protesters over the last, you know, matter of fact, this year. And a bunch of, man, a few thousand been arrested. And, oh, man, it's a mess over there in France, okay? Because they upset. You follow me? Here, you understand? Say, Paris police skirmished Saturday with yellow vest activists who joined a wave of protests against the government's overhaul of France's retirement system. Just like they're going to have to do here in America. I know they're going to have to do it here in Illinois, in Chicago. And I know there's other places they're going to have to do it. All right? Overhaul, right? Of France's retirement system as highway blockades and train stoppages by other protesters disrupted weekend travel around the country. Now, tell you, soon coming here to America, December the 9th, Chicago Tribune, say Brazil can't stop deforestation without help. Okay? You understand? Say this is out of Madrid, Brazil. Can't stop deforestation in the Amazon without the help of rich countries. The country's environment minister said at the United Nations 2-week climate change conference. Okay? Now, see, they in trouble economically. And this is all, you understand, promulgated by the Illuminated Edomite. Like I said, the house of Rothschild, the family, the house of Rothschild is worth $500 trillion. Half the money of the world. Now, that's, you understand? They own half of all the money in the world. Now, see? Amalekite International Bank and Edomite. Got the dominion. But what is y'all saying? Numbers chapter 24 is latter end. It's going to perish. They're going to perish forever. These Amalekites. You understand? Because they fighting against y'all. Okay? Exodus chapter 17. Chicago Tribune, December the 9th. Tourists missing after volcano erupts on New Zealand Island. You understand? And this brother I know, he was telling me a few months ago he was going to New Zealand and Australia. You understand? And I know y'all done heard about Australia. I got some stuff in the stash about that. Okay? But they had a volcano over in New Zealand. Okay? Devastating factory fire kills at least 43 in Indian capital. That's out of New Delhi. Okay? Also, shooting survivor sues South Carolina. Shooting survivor sued South California or Southern California synagogue. Okay? Said, this is out of Poway, California. A man wounded in a shooting at a San Diego area synagogue is suing the house of worship, alleging Chabad of Poway didn't use federal funds meant to hire security to protect worshipers, according to a newspaper report. In the lawsuit obtained by Los Angeles Times, Almog Peretz claims the synagogue did not have proper security despite a rise in anti-Semitic attacks nationally and that it did not use a $150,000 grant to upgrade safety. Okay? Now, you know Esau got that money from the government. They used it for something else. Say, we don't need no security. You know, who the Edomites, what they call on? Hashem, okay? Hashem, right? You understand what I mean? That's supposed to be who they call on, whatever that is. That's just like Jehovah and Yahweh and Yahweh and Yahuwah and Yahweh. You understand what I'm saying? You know, whoever this Hashem is. So I guess they say Hashem going to protect us, but Hashem wasn't protecting them, was it? Okay? I tell you, boy. Also, in the Ukraine and the International Monetary Fund, the IMF, right, have reached agreement on a new $5.5 billion program to boost the country's growth and economic reform. Now, that's Esau. The Illuminated Edomite through the IMF just sunk their teeth in the neck of the Ukraine. You understand? Ukraine going to take $5.5 billion loan. Huh? The agreement, which still must be approved by the fund's management, was reached in a Saturday telephone call between Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky. Isn't that who Trump was talking to about this Biden, Hunter Biden situation? And IMF Managing Director Kristalina Georgieva. The IMF is based in Washington, D.C. Okay, now, say details of how the money would be used over the plan's 3 years weren't given. Zelensky, who was elected in April on a platform focusing on economic reforms and fighting corruption, said in a statement that the program will accelerate growth. Yeah, right. You follow me? Esau coming, you understand, with the loan. And once they take the loan, it's over. Esau got his teeth in your neck, in the Ukraine's neck. Huh? Boy. Chicago Tribune, December the 10th. Afghan war progress question. Three administrations misled the public, documents show. Huh? This is out of D.C., right? The U.S. government across three White House administrations misled the public about failures in the Afghanistan war, often suggesting success where it didn't exist. According to thousands of pages of documents obtained by the Washington Post. All right. Also, I just heard here on Lee Camp's show a few weeks ago. You understand? Matter of fact, it wasn't Lee Camp's show. It was Jesse Ventura's show on RT. Lee Camp said, you understand, the most outstanding thing that happened that he heard about, you know, in this 2019, right, was that the Pentagon had spent $21 trillion in the last, the last like 10 years, and they don't know where it went. It can't be accounted for. $21 trillion that they can't account for. Now, I think it was 21 trillion. I think I got something else in the stage. It was 21 trillion or 81 trillion. It was a lot of money that they cannot account for what they did with it. Now, and all these wars, right? Now, that's the UN was supposed to be set up to keep war from happening. You ain't had nothing but war since it's been set up. Okay? Said, let me just read this out of this article about the Afghan war question, right? I tell you, boy, how much money they done spent on it? It says, what did we get for this $1 trillion effort? Was it worth $1 trillion? Again, since 2001, the Defense Department, State Department, and U.S. Agency for International Development have spent or appropriated between $934 billion $978 billion for this Afghan war, right? According to an inflation-adjusted estimate calculated by Netta Crawford, a political science professor and co-director of the Cost of War Project at Brown University, the Post reported. See, those figures do not include money spent by other agencies such as the CIA and Department of Veterans Affairs, which is responsible for medical care for wounded veterans. What did we get for this $1 trillion effort? Was it worth $1 trillion? Jeffrey Eggers, a retired Navy SEAL and White House staffer for President George W. Bush and Barack Obama, told government interviewers. He added, after the killing of Osama bin Laden, I said that Osama was probably laughing in his watery grave, considering how much we have spent on Afghanistan. Okay? Now, they spent all that money on war. You follow what I'm saying? And here you got people over here starving. People homeless, right? People living in squalor, right? You follow me? Like I said, that billions of dollars they talking about, they going to need to shore up the barriers around South Carolina. They can forget that. Okay? Because, again, the dollar is collapsing in value, being inflated as I speak. It's losing buying power every second of every day. Also, up to 13 feared dead in volcanic eruption off New Zealand coast. See, again, it's stuff everywhere. Okay? Everywhere. Chicago Tribune, December 11th, right? Saudi prince's ambitions tied to Trump triumphant Aramco sale. All right? Okay? The Saudis selling stock in Aramco. Right? And again, you only sell stock when you what? When you cash poor. When you need liquidity. That's when you sell stock. All right? So the Saudis need cash. They cash poor. Liquidity. All right? And check this, what I wrote this in, because I heard this off, the news on RT. Not those ABC, CBS, NBC, NC, whatever you, CNBC, whatever they call that nonsense. Fine. You don't get none of this real news off of them. Now listen to this. The Saudis are selling three times more stock, than actually they had on the market. In other words, they show one share three times. Okay? Now, don't go figure that one. That's against the law. That's fraud. You follow what I'm saying? Nah. Okay? Nah. You understand? Tell you, boy. Chicago Tribune, December the 12th. Fears rise. Pair targeted. Jewish store. Mayor of New Jersey City calls deadly market attack a hate crime. Now, this is the Edomites perpetrating these attacks by us. Supposedly on them, at least those who look like us. Okay, because this one that just jumped off with this guy named Thomas, right? I know y'all heard about it. I got some stuff in the stash later on. I'm going to read about it, right? And more than likely, he was a Manchurian candidate. Okay, and I'll talk about that later. But this one that happened in New Jersey, right? Supposedly this brother and this sister. You hear what I say? Supposedly, right? And they were supposed to have been of a Hebrew Israelite group. So you see where they're going. Right? Because they know, you understand, this truth is coming out through Yah Rising. So now they more than likely perpetrating this nonsense, you understand, to want to impugn, you follow what I'm saying? You understand, Hebrew Israelite groups. But again, whatever they put out, they can't put out anything. I mean, they can say something adverse about Yah Rising if they want to, which I doubt. You follow me? Because they don't want anybody's attention to be diverted to Yah Righteousness. You understand what I'm saying? So they're going to probably try to impugn some of these other Hebrew Israelite movements, right? You follow me? But again, anybody that's been plugged into Yah Righteousness, you don't hear us spewing out any hate against any people. Now, quite naturally, we talk about the Edomites for who they are, Edomites. See, because when Esau is trying to perpetrate this anti-Semitism, like these Edomites is the only Semites in the world. Semites are Shemites, right? But I'm a Shemite. You understand? All Israelites are Shemites because we come out of Shem, like our forefather Abraham. You follow what I'm saying? Just like the Edomites come out of Abraham, they Shemites, but we Shemites too. Just like the so-called Palestinians who are really Israel, they Shemites. You understand? Even if they, you understand, were what Esau calls them, Arabs, you understand, like out of Ishmael, they Shemites. You follow me? You know what I'm saying? But Esau tried to make it like the only Shemites in the world are these Jews, these Edomites. Okay? So again, say I circled this again. Fears rise, pair targeted Jewish store, right? Fears that a deadly shooting at a Jewish market in Jersey City was an anti-Semitic attack. But again, if this brother and sister did it, which I doubt, because what I saw, no telling who actually was doing the shoot. They might have had them, killed already and brought them out as the perpetrators, right? But nevertheless, they were Shemites. You understand what I'm saying? Say attack mounted Wednesday, authorities recounted how a man and woman deliberately pulled up to the place in a rental van with at least one rifle and got out firing. I mean, they just come out of nowhere. You know what I mean? And they don't really give you any history about them. They just say they was connected to some Hebrew Israelite group. I think it was ISUPK. You understand? Because we saw them talking about it. Some ISUPK representative at their place, with they got the 6-pointed star, the star Esau up on the wall. You understand what I'm saying? Okay, but check this out. Say also investigators. No, let me go back up one paragraph. Said this, but Mayor Steve Fulop said surveillance video of the attackers made it clear they targeted the kosher market, and he pronounced the bloodshed a hate crime against Jews, as did New York's mayor and governor. Also, investigators believe the two attackers, who were believed to be a couple, identified themselves in the past as Black Hebrew Israelites, right? A movement whose members, all Israelites that, you understand? You follow what I'm saying? Participate, are all about the same movement, right? Black Hebrew Israelites, a movement whose members have been known to rail against whites and Jews, according to a law enforcement official who was briefed on the matter but was not authorized to discuss the case publicly and spoke on condition of anonymity. Right. In addition, authorities have found social media postings from at least one of the killers that were anti-police and anti-Jewish, the official said. The FBI on Wednesday searched the Harlem headquarters of the Israelite Church of God and Jesus Christ. Okay, you follow what I'm saying? So again, these Israelites that are in idolatries, I can't say they wouldn't do something crazy, but at the same time, they not about Yah, right? I just read who they about, JC, right? Esau's idol that he perpetrated, which is the formal name of Black Hebrew group, of the Black Hebrew group, okay? So they say the Israelite Church of God in JC, right? Says the killers were identified, again, as David N. Anderson, 47, and Francine Graham, 50. Both of them also prime suspects in the slaying of a livery driver found dead in a car trunk in nearby Bayonne over the weekend. Anderson served about 4 months in prison in New Jersey on weapons charges and was paroled in 2011. So they again, who knows what the real deal is about that, okay? But like I said, together with this last one, they're trying to impugn Israelite movements. That's what they're trying to do. Because this last thing here the other day, when I get to it, I look at him as a maturing candidate, okay? But nevertheless, the Chicago Tribune, December the 12th. Rescuer describes horror of New Zealand's silent eruption. Volcano, silent eruption, right? Okay. I tell you, boy, the eruption was so silent that Lelani Hopkins didn't hear it over the hum of the boat's engines. She didn't turn around until her dad whacked or hit her. Like, look at that, okay? A silent volcanic eruption in New Zealand. Okay. Also, America's world influence declining. Okay, they got a picture of your president, Donald Trump, right? They say America's world, that's how I say it. I don't use that mind control term, right? America's world influence declining. With Trump in power, allies look to China and Russia. Okay? Now, I'm going to show you this. Okay? You see that, don't you? Okay? You see that, don't you? Okay? America's influence is declining. Because many of these nations now, they're going over to China and Russia. Okay? Germany, you know, they all hooking up together. America don't have it. You understand? Again, that influence, that power anymore. Okay? Countries is hip to America. Chicago Tribune, December the 12th. French government raises age to retire as strikes grind on. Okay? Not only did they cut the pensions, they raising the age to retire. Okay? Over in France. Man, they said the day after, France's prime minister said Wednesday that the full retirement age would be increased for the country's youngest, but offered concessions in an ill-fated effort to calm a nationwide protest against pension reforms that critics say will erode the nation's way of life. You hear that? Okay, the government says it wants to make the pension system sustainable and simpler, but is facing public pressure, including a week of the most debilitating transport strikes in decades. Okay, said major unions were quick to reject the proposals and vowed to strike on the day after more than 300,000 people protested across France. Metro lines in Paris, but two were closed and many train routes remain canceled as unions dig in their heels against President Emmanuel Macron, whom they accuse of shaping policies in favor of the rich. Okay? Said people born after 1974 will have to work until age 64 to get a full pension instead of 62 previously. So they jacked it up 2 years. The French is upset. Okay, but like I said, soon to be coming here to America. That's already started hiking up the retirement age, but a lot of this retirement pension funds is gone, and people going to find that out. And people are already finding out, but it's going to hit even more than what has hit already. Chicago Sun-Tan, December the 13th, rejoicing over reparations vote. Danny Glover, national activist, converge on Evanston, that's a little suburb north of Chicago, as city funds amends for African Americans with cannabis tax. See, now, you understand? So this Evanston, Illinois, you follow me? They voted to, when they legalized marijuana, they voted to take so much money from the taxing of marijuana and provide it for, you know, reparations for us. You understand what I'm saying? Said actor Danny Glover told an Evanston town hall Wednesday night the Chicago suburb will go down in history as having led the way in the reparations movement with its groundbreaking legislation funding amends for African Americans with a cannabis sales tax. Okay, say on November 25th, the Evanston City Council passed the proposal by this alderman establishing a $10 million reparations fund making amends to its African-American population for historic wrongs traced to racial inequities in the affluent north suburb. So, let me just finish reading some of these places I got marked. Say it will be seeded by a 3% tax on cannabis sales after recreational marijuana becomes legal in Illinois the 1st of January, which is today, which made sense after studies found 71% of the town's marijuana arrests had been in African-American communities. All right? Now, you tell me, this is an affluent suburb. Many Edomites and Caucasians live out there, you know, in Evanston, Illinois. And so you mean to tell me we the only ones smoking marijuana out there? 71% of the arrests in this northern suburb, Evanston, which is an affluent suburb, right? 71% of the arrests for having marijuana or cannabis, right, was on us. And we don't even make up nowhere near the majority of the people that live in Evanston. You follow me? But we represent 71% of the arrests. All right? So now they're going to put a 3% sales tax, you understand, on the cannabis sold in Evanston, and set that money aside to stimulate, you know, us that live up there in Evanston. But, you know, that ain't going to do any, you know, that ain't going to really make no big deal because, again, you getting many of us and other Caucasians that are not affluent that live in Evanston, they getting cut back from these different government subsidies. And they know many of us going to get cut back. You follow what I'm saying? Moved off the SNAP rolls or cut back. So, you understand? You understand? We'll lose, say, 10% and we'll get 3% from the sales. You understand what I mean? We're still running insane, is my point. Okay? Say, the late U.S. Representative John Conyers first introduced the reparations bill and reintroduced it every congressional session. Okay? U.S. Representative Sheila Jackson Lee, a Democrat out of Texas, is new sponsor of a bill to authorize $12 million to fund a 13-member commission co-sponsored by 64 Democrats. So they authorizing a $12 million fund to sponsor 13 members to study this. Now, how much money they going to make off the fund? And $13 million ain't no money, just like $10 million ain't no money. You understand what I'm saying? And not with the eroding dollar, right? The buying power of the dollar eroding, right? See, we understand the expansiveness of this idea. It's about telling the truth. What's the truth? If we cannot tell ourselves the truth about our past, we become trapped in it. We've been in conversations about reparations, but action is taking place right here, said Glover. Now, he's talking about recognizing the truth about the past. Glover don't even understand what the past is. Now, he Israelite don't understand it, more likely than not. You understand what I'm saying? That's our past. You know, he's talking about recognizing the truth of the past. You know, tell you, boy. Woo, man. Chicago Tribune, December the 13th. Again, the same article, hundreds pack Evanston Church, right, to discuss local reparations fund. Okay, because again, the event, which was promoted but not sponsored by the city, was designed as a celebration of Evanston's reparation initiative and the start of a continuing dialogue. The fund will be capped at $10 million, and officials say it will be used to help the city's black community with economic development, education, and housing, among other issues. The fund will be paid for with a 3% sales tax on adult recreational marijuana, which becomes legal in Illinois this today, January 1st. So like I said, so they gonna cut other programs we being cut off of, and then they gonna stick this sales tax for marijuana and to try to shore up where we getting cut in other areas. You understand what I'm saying? And it ain't gonna be enough. Okay, so they gonna call it a reparations tax. Okay? You understand? I tell you, boy. Game is on. Chicago Tribune, December the 13th. New Jersey attack investigated as domestic terrorism. Huh? State Attorney General says hatred fueled fatal shooting at Jewish market. So, again, like I said, now they're trying to impugn Israelite movements, right? And you know what they're going to try to do? Try to lump us all in. Because I guarantee you, they will never mention Y'all Righteousness Movement. I guarantee you that. Okay? They're not going to do that. Right? Because they don't want to draw attention to it. They might mention, you understand, like I said, that Church of God and Christ nonsense, right? You follow me? But they're going to try to impugn all Israelite movements to make all of them as, you know, so, like we hate Jews, Edomites, you understand? Hate Caucasians, so-called white folks, you know? But like I said, anybody that comes to Yah Righteousness and goes through the website meticulously, you're not going to hear that. You're going to hear judgment. That's what you're going to hear. You're going to hear the words of Yah, you understand, out of this book of remembrance, okay? But we don't hate anybody, okay? We understand. Chicago Tribune, December the 13th. Trump slams teen climate activist election in time as ridiculous. You know that Greta Thunberg or Thunberg, right? President Donald Trump lashed out at 16-year-old climate activist Greta Thunberg on Thursday. Some people pronounce it Thunberg, right? A day after she was named by Time magazine as its person of the year, calling her selection ridiculous. Okay, now that show you how they, you know, they don't want anything about this climate. Because Esau knows only Yah can straighten it out. That's why he don't want to talk about it. That's why Trump, you understand, these presidents, they ain't going to talk about no climate situation. Okay, you understand? Okay, also ex-Bolivian leader Morales given asylum in Argentina. That's Evo Morales. You know, America cooed him. Illuminated Edomite, you understand, cooed him. See, because again, Bolivia has got the biggest deposit of lithium in the world, besides other national resources, right? You follow me? Natural resources, besides lithium. And you know they need lithium for what? For these batteries, for these cars and trucks. And these cell phones and whatnot, these computers, lithium, you understand? See, so you know they want that. So that's why they, one of the reasons why they cooed Evo Morales. And that's why the people down there is protesting big time. Because Evo Morales won the election by 10 plus points. A solid 10 points he won the election. You follow me? In America, they going to claim that, you know, the election wasn't fair, it wasn't a plurality, you understand? But I was listening to Greg Palance here the other day. He said anytime you win an election by 10 points or better, that's a landslide. That's the same thing with Maduro in Venezuela. Landslide. You follow me? Just like I read this article about this Guaido. I got it later on. I get to it. Again, Chicago Tribune, December the 13th, Illinois layoffs top 1,000 for second month in a row. You follow me? Layoffs top 1,000 for second month in a row. Sears, Kmart, parent company let go nearly 200 in November. Now that's doing supposed to be the, you understand, the height of the holiday season. And they were laying people off in November. You follow me? So, you understand? They wasn't doing too good, huh? I tell you, boy. Like Michelle Alexander said, the truth is not too popular, huh? Chicago Tribune, December 15th. And she said that a few years ago. December 15th, Chicago Tribune, coral reefs are dying. Okay, you hear that? Show it to you. Coral reefs are dying. Okay? Shed scientists are searching for a chance for their survival. Okay? Says, this is out of the Bahamas. Wetsuit still zipped up to his neck from an earlier dive. Ross Cunning stands amid dozens of chunks of coral in the saltwater live well on board the Coral Reef 2, the research vessel owned by his employer, Chicago's Shedd Aquarium. He's a research scientist by trade, but his tools at the moment are decidedly low-tech. Cunning has zip ties. He's got long line clips, the quick release fasteners used on deep sea fishing rigs, temporarily oblivious to his Bahamian coastal surroundings or the steady rocking of the 80-foot boat. He is attaching the live coral fragments to the rungs of ladder-like structures he and his team made out of PVC pipe and cord. Metaphorically, the animals are canaries in the climate change coal mine. Literally, they are staghorn coral, each about 5 inches long, each destined to be moved by the racks to an open ocean underwater nursery as part of the researchers' experiment to identify the hardiest, most heat-resistant corals, knowledge made desperately necessary by Earth's ever hotter areas, or hotter seas, excuse me, by the Earth's ever hotter seas. The seas and the oceans is getting hotter from the acidity, okay? And again, from that Fukushima with all that radioactivity being spewed out the last 5+ years, right? They say climate change reaches every reef on the planet. And so I think people are realizing that we have to do everything we can to try to, turn the tide. But they're not going to be able to. Only Yah can change this. And he's only going to start once his temple, is built and completed. Ezekiel chapter 47, when the healing waters come out. And he's the only one who can open the windows to the dome, which he's going to do again, Yeshua chapter 24, at the destruction of this daughter of Babylon. Okay? So, I tell you, they want to turn a blind eye. You understand? But that's why, again, these people of stature, these elite, they're the ones coming to the way of the Most High. See, because the average person out here in the world, they're not knowledgeable enough to know what's really going on. Like it says, in Yeshua chapter 60, the earth is in darkness, the people of the earth in gross darkness, right? And here's an article here. It said, Trump fights anti-Semitism one day, and then he fuels anti-Semitism the next day. Okay? All right? Because, Trump said any of these Jews that don't vote for him, you understand, they going against their own. Okay? Say Jewish Democratic Council of America Executive Director Hallie Sofer said in a statement December 8th that Trump used anti-Semitic stereotypes to characterize Jews as driven by money and insufficiently loyal to Israel. Jewish advocacy group J Street tweeted that the president is incapable of addressing Jewish audiences without dipping into the deep well of anti-Semitic tropes that shape his worldview. Okay. I tell you, boy. Oh, man. Chicago Tribune, December the 15th. What speech counts as anti-Semitic? Order would widen scope of complaints on college campuses. See? Now it says, President Donald Trump's order to expand the scope of potential anti-Semitism complaints on college campuses is raising the stakes of an already tense battle over how to define discrimination against Jews. The executive order Trump signed Wednesday tells the Education Department when vetting alleged Civil Rights Act violations that can lead to a loss of schools' federal funding to consider a definition of anti-Semitism that could include some criticism of Israel. So, again, if you criticize them Edomites who call themselves Israel and are not, then that can be construed as anti-Semitism. And it, like I said earlier, it doesn't even make any difference. If you a Semite, you're going to be called an anti-Semite or Shemite, you know what I'm saying? If you criticize them Edomites for what they're doing over there and what they've been doing to this very day in, you understand, executing an apartheid system, right, and committing genocide on other Shemites, so-called Palestinians, who are really Israelites. Okay, said for supporters of Trump's order, which is aligned with bipartisan legislation that had stalled, the distinction is a clear matter of reining in those who would question the Edomites' right to exist as a Jewish nation. Okay, says Jared Kushner, Trump's son-in-law and senior advisor, and he's an Edomite, Jared Kushner, right? Wrote in New York Times op-ed that The order's broadened definition will convey the administration's position that anti-Zionism is anti-Semitism. See, so this Jared Kushner, who's a pawn of the Illuminated Edomite without a doubt, right? He confers with Henry Kissinger on a regular basis. I've talked about that in the past. He's written this order up. You understand that Trump is signed and put out there, right? That anti-Zionism is anti-Semitism. See, but Zionism, is a political ideology. You follow me? As is Judaism. It's a theology, but it's still a political ideology, but it's a religion. Just like Christianity, just like Islam. You follow me? Religions. And all religions come out of the hearts of men or man. Right? I tell you, boy. So, again, yeah, you know, they trying to, because they know, you understand, that this truth, you understand, Yah is bringing this truth out through his movement. You understand? You understand? By his holy name, Yah righteousness. You understand? And so, you know, they perpetrate these attacks that we're supposed to be doing on these Edomites, right? And I saw that right out. I know what they trying to do. You understand what I mean? Impute, as they like to call it, black Hebrew Israelite movements. You follow me? Because they don't want, they ain't going to mention, they not going to say Yah righteousness. They not going to do that. Okay? I can tell you that now. They not going to do that. Okay? So they don't want to, you understand? They looking at it, whoever's not knowledgeable of Yah righteousness, we want to keep them like that. So they going to try to throw a blanket over all Hebrew Israelite groups, right? So that's where they try to craft little stuff, but it stick out like a sore thumb. Because you could be, you understand, I heard Caucasians, they anti-Zionists, just like you got Edomites that's anti-Zionists, right? But they're not anti-Shemitic or Semitic, as they like to use the term, right? Same thing, right? Chicago Tribune, December the 15th. As firefighter makes his way through a flooded neighborhood Saturday after heavy rains the day before in southwestern France. One person died and five others were injured as the floods threatened the Pyrenees Atlanticus region. About 70,000 homes lost power. See, this flood going on everywhere. Yeah, it's hitting the whole world. You know what I mean? Different parts. Also under pressure, Hallmark pulls gay-themed wedding TV ads. Okay? You understand? I got something else about that, though. You know, Hallmark got this pressure, so they pulled these gay-themed wedding TV ads, okay, when they got this pressure. But I got something else about that in a minute. December the 16th, right? Now, this is December the 16th, a few days later, right? Or one day later, Hallmark Channel reinstating ad of same-sex wedding. Okay? So they pulled it when they got some pressure, then they put it back when they got some other pressure from high up, right? Okay? So the Hallmark Channel will reinstate same-sex marriage commercials that it pulled from the network, according to a company statement since Sunday. An ad for wedding planning citing Zola featuring two brides kissing at the altar was pulled following a complaint from the conservative group of 1 million moms. A Hallmark spokesperson previously told the Associated Press that the network pulled the ad because the controversy was creating a distraction. Okay? I tell you, boy. Woo! Man. Moral depravity. Moral collapse, huh? Chicago Tribune, December 16th. Protests turned violent for second day in Lebanon's capital. You know, I mentioned Lebanon earlier. They got protests over there because, again, economic chokehold. Huh? You understand? Economic, you understand? System is collapsing right under their feet. Okay? And it's going on across the earth, right? Say Lebanese security forces fired tear gas and rubber bullets and water cannons Sunday to disperse hundreds of protesters for a second straight day, ending what started as a peaceful rally in defiance of the toughest crackdown on anti-government demonstrations in 2 months. The violence comes on the eve of a meeting between the president and parliamentary blocs, in which resigned Prime Minister Saeed Hariri is widely expected to be renamed to the post. The tension also reflects a deepening divisions in the country that is grappling with severe liquidity and foreign currency crunch. See, no liquidity. Just like I said about the Saudis. The only reason they offered up this stock, because they need cash. They're cash poor. All right, but also, they were selling three times, you know, they were selling one share of stock three times, in other words, right? Which is fraud. Three times more stock than what, you understand, than what they had, they selling. You understand what I mean? So it's fraud. Okay? In the Philippines, a strong earthquake jolted the southern Philippines on Sunday, killing at least one person and causing a three-story building to collapse, setting off a search for people feared to have been trapped inside. 3.7 on the Richter scale. Matter of fact, no, I'll take that back. 6.9 quake struck an area about 3.7 miles. So it was 6.7. That's a big one, man. That's in the Philippines. Tell you, something going on everywhere. All these idolatrous countries, all these idolatrous people on the earth. All right. December 16th, Chicago Tribune. Now, this is an Israelite here. You know, Michelle Obama's cousin, okay, mentioned him in the past, Rabbi Funai, other black Hebrew Israelites wrongly connected to Jersey City shooters. See, and this is Papers Funai, okay, Michelle Obama's cousin, that's him there, okay? You know, I mentioned him in the past, they right over here southwest of us, okay? Now, they in the Judaism. Used to be Hasidism before it became Judaism. All right? So, you understand? That reminds me of that line. Where is it? Some of you out there know I'm not that fluent in the New Testament. Where it says, I think it's in Revelation, where it says, like in the end time or something, you're going to have those who call themselves Jews who are really, who are not Jews. But really of the synagogue of Satan, that's this that's these Israelites like this Capers Funai, right, who call themselves Jews and are not, but really are the synagogue of Satan, which is, you understand, Hasidism that evolved into Judaism, because they in the Judaism, so they in the synagogue of Satan, which is the synagogue of the adversary, which is the Edomites, right? And they call themselves Jews, but they're not. Because you got any Israelite out here calling themselves a Jew, you know they're confused. See, that puts them in the synagogue of the adversary, of the satanic ones. The synagogue of Satan, which puts them in with these synagogues, with these Edomites, these Jews. Because they're in the Judaism. There used to be Hasidism that was begun by Esau back in 300 BCE. Okay? Now, it says, a Chicago rabbi, Capers Funai, had two reactions when some news outlets, including the New York Times, reported Wednesday that a man and a woman who killed six people at a kosher market in Jersey City, New Jersey, had ties to the black Hebrew Israelites, and that the Southern Poverty Law Center identified the black Hebrew Israelites as a fringe hate group unaffiliated with mainstream Judaism. See? So you see what they trying to do, all right? You understand what I said earlier, right? They're going to try to impugn all Hebrew Israelite groups. You follow me? Especially with this label black, right? And then they're going to say, you know, they're not into mainstream Judaism. Well, YHWH righteousness is not into Judaism at all, okay? Never has been and never will be, okay? Now check this Capus Funai what he said. I feel terrible that innocent lives were taken first and foremost, said Funai, rabbi for 26 years of the 200-member Beth Shalom B'nai Zaken Ethiopian Hebrew Congregation of Chicago, a member of the Chicago Board of Rabbis and the chief rabbi of the International Israelite Board of Rabbis. Now, all of these real Israelites that's part of that nonsense, they're into Judaism. They're not about Yah at all. Okay? I tell you, boy. Whew, man. And let me just read it. Say, the Black Israelite movement began. Let me go back a little bit more. It says, boy, I tell you. Rabbi Bruce Elder of Congregation Hakafa in Glencoe, that's another northern suburb beyond Evanston that I just mentioned, right? These are rich, wealthy suburbs north of Chicago. So this Rabbi Bruce Elder of Congregation Hakafa in Glencoe, a former member of the Chicago Board of Rabbis who has known Funai for 30 years, caused this week's incident one more assault on Black Africans. An indignation with assumptions being made. Too many African-American Jews, he says, still feel unwelcome in predominantly white congregations. Funai wants to be a bridge builder who brings Black and white Jews together. The Jewish Council on Urban Affairs recently gave Funai its Robert J. Marks Social Justice Award for his efforts to combat racism and anti-Semitism locally and nationally. Quote, we see Rabbi Funai and his congregation as completely part of our Jewish community in Chicago, says Executive Director Judy Levy. The Black Israelite movement began in the late 19th century and was made up largely of African Americans who believed they were descendants of the lost tribes of ancient Israelites. You hear that? Now, that's correct. You understand the late 19th century, 1896, right? Now, you see what Esau's saying here, huh? Was made up largely of African Americans who believed they were descendants of the lost tribes of ancient Israelites. Funai, a cousin of Michelle Obama, was born in South Carolina and raised on the south side of Chicago in the African Methodist Episcopal Church. While attending Howard University, he became interested in Judaism and began studying with Rabbi Robert Devine, who practiced a form of Messianic Judaism. Later, Funai was drawn to the more conventional teachings of a Black Brooklyn-based rabbi, Levi Ben Levi, who taught him Biblical Hebrew, okay, so that's what, Yiddish, and standard religious text from an African perspective. Funai took his ordination with the Israelite Board of Rabbis and later participated in two conversion rituals with a panel of conservative and Orthodox rabbis, a practice he recommends to his congregants. Since then, he has earned both a bachelor's and master's degree from the Spertus Institute for Jewish Learning and Leadership. You know, that's the school we were going to. You understand that I've talked about in the past, back in 75 and the early part of 76, the latter part of 75, the early part of 76, until I got to Zephaniah chapter 3. And from reading Zephaniah chapter 3, realized this is Hebrew Edomite we were studying. And when I brought it to the other three brothers, like I said in the past, you know, it took a few minutes, but then they could see it. And then we all stopped going to Spertus College. You understand? Because that's Hebrew Edomite. That's Yiddish. So this is what this Capus Funai done learned. And with his degrees going to Spertus College, right? Even some traditional Jews who do not worship with Black Israelites object to negative portrayals of all its adherents. Okay? Yeah, I bet you do. Because again, Esau would love to have us all into that Judaism. You understand what I'm saying? That's why he created it, right? Just like he created Christianity and Islam and all the rest of that. It's nonsense. Chicago Tribune, December the 17th. Protests reignite across India against new citizenship law. Okay? All right? Okay? Fresh protests swept India on Monday, a day after police entered a university campus in the nation's capital and injured hundreds of students who were expressing opposition to a controversial new citizenship law. Okay? Said demonstrations in at least 17 cities Monday were part of a wave of unrest that has gripped India after the passage of the citizenship law on December 11th. The measure was a priority for Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who won re-election in May and has moved to implement his party's agenda of emphasizing Hindu primacy. Okay, some more, you know, who knows? Esau might have created Hinduism too. Okay, religions, right? The law introduced religion as a criteria for nationality and created an expedited path towards citizenship for migrants who belong to six religions, including Islam, the faith practiced by 200 million Indians. Okay? Oh, man. Argentina took loans from the IMF, too. Okay? You understand what I'm saying? Argentina is taking loans from the IMF. So, you know, Esau has got his teeth sunk into the neck of the Argentinians. Because they protesting down there, too. Because when you take that money from the IMF, as we said in the past, now they're going to start putting these, you understand, controls on your economy and on the people. And things gonna go up in price, huh? And they're gonna attack the people's income, you know, and you're gonna be making less, paying more to pay back these loans. See? And Esau, once he does this, he gets control of your economy. See? And once he's got control of your economy, he got you. You know, you understand, he gonna start taking your natural resources, whatever they are. Okay? Whatever they are. But that's what he wants. He wants, you follow me, the control of your economy. So he took control of your natural resources. Okay, that's what it's all about. I tell you, man, it's people just can't grab it. You know, they can't see. They just can't see it. Chicago Sun-Times, December 18th. House okays budget package to avoid shutdown. The Democratic-controlled House voted Tuesday to pass a $1.4 trillion government-wide spending package. Now, you understand, you get these Republicans and Democrats, they can't agree on anything, but they agree on these budgets. $1.4 trillion. Every year it gets higher and higher. Because, you know, 2018 was the first year, you follow me, 2018 to 2019, that America wasn't taking in enough taxes to pay the interest on the debt. Okay? So they're not going to take in enough taxes to pay the interest on the debt this year either. So you're running a double deficit. You follow what I'm saying? Pentagon spent $21 trillion, this is where I wrote it, what I mentioned a minute ago. Pentagon spent $21 trillion unaccounted dollars, huh, for it in its budget over 21 years. So it's $1 trillion a year that the Pentagon spent, and they in the budget they can't account where the money went, what the money was used for. And that's what Lee Camp was talking about on Jesse Ventura's show here the other week. When they were talking about, Jesse Ventura asked him, you know, what's the most salient thing, you know, that sticks out to you for the year 2019? So Lee Camp said, you know, when the Pentagon put forth their budget, you know, you understand, revealed what, you know, their budget for the past 21 years, you know, and they revealed it back in like, it came out in 2019, you know, last year now, right? He said when he looked at it, $21 trillion, they don't know where it went. At least that's what they're telling everybody. Now, if we do that on our taxes and say, you know, well, I had $20 million or $1 million, you know what I mean? And I made it, but I don't know. I don't know what I did with it. So I'm not putting it on my taxes. You know, they'll come on you and say, well, you know, we got you spending this much money. Well, I don't know what I did with that. I sent you what I sent you. So you just, you know, we get in trouble, right? But this is the Pentagon, man. $21 trillion for 21 years. $1 trillion a year unaccounted for. Okay? And that was in the 2018 budget that they just revealed, you know, last year. Right? Tell you, boy. Inequities. Chicago Sun-Tan, December the 18th, huh? Former Northbrook woman is victim of New Zealand volcano. So a woman in Northbrook, which is north, you know, northern part of Chicago where, you know, people, well-to-do people live, she got caught up and she got killed. Okay? She got killed in that New Zealand volcano. All right. Also, again, like I was mentioning earlier, Fukushima still spilling out radiation over 5 years. Pacific Ocean is filled with radiation. All right. And another thing, for those of you, we've mentioned it in the past, because this came out here a few weeks ago. This person was saying, this show I watch here in Chicago, how he mentioned, because he, you know, goes on the internet, and he brought this up and brought this out. You know, we mentioned it here a while back when Stacey Herbert Mitch and Max Kaiser went on a trip across the country, and Stacey Herbert brought out how they was driving, you know, in all these different states and whatnot, and no bugs on the windshield. Well, this person I watch here in Chicago, you understand, he brought this out here a few weeks ago where it's up on the internet. I didn't get the site, but this person said that they traveled between L.A. and Las Vegas. And they had traveled between L.A. and Las Vegas so many times over so many months. Estimated like 4,000 miles altogether in these trips back and forth between L.A. and Las Vegas. And no bugs on the windshield. They said they did not have to wash the car one time. See, and I've noticed that here when I'm on the expressway, you understand, going back and forth, like, you understand, over to Indiana, you follow what I'm saying? And I'm just on the expressway, you don't get any bugs on the windshield when you out, way out on these expressways, you know, around, you understand, foliage and trees, whatnot. No bugs on the windshield. See, now that's indicative that the insects are dying off in droves. You follow me? Dying off in droves. So with no insects, what are the birds going to eat? You know the article I read here, what was it, last month, a couple of months ago? You understand? All these birds have died off here in Illinois. Now this is in other states too, and in America and in other countries, but definitely here, you understand, in America and in the state of Illinois, the birds is dying off because there's no insects to eat. Now, you remember what I said, you know, how Yoshi had brought that to me, and I talked about it, I think, last month again, about, you understand, when the wolves, they thought the wolves was multiplying rapidly out there in Yellowstone Park. So this is years ago, right, 70-something years ago, so they killed off all the wolves, just about, right? And then that caused the deer to multiply. Then the deer started eating up all the shrubs. And then the insects dissipated. And when the insects dissipated, the birds dissipated, right? You know, left, right? Ain't no birds, no insects, no birds, right? And then you understand how the no foliage, no little small trees and shrub. So the beaver left. Because the beaver be using them shrubs and little trees to make dams in the lakes and whatnot, right? And so they left. Then when the beavers left, a lot of the water life, you understand, the lakes and the whatnot, the rivers, a lot of that aquatic life left, right? And it's just a mess, right? And after about 7 years, they figured it out, and so they imported more wolves. The wolves started eating the deer. The deer started eating, you understand, because they being eaten up. They less foliage. The foliage started growing back. So the insects came back. So the birds came back, right? So the beavers came back. So the aquatic life in the rivers and the lakes came back. You follow what I'm saying? Man taking everything out of Yah's natural order. So now insects are dying off in droves. Because if you can drive a car on the highway and go from state to state, and you don't get any bugs on the windshield, well, you understand, it used to be, as soon as you went on the highway, you come back, you didn't have to go real far. You got bugs all over the front of your car, all on the windshield. You had to come back and wash your car. Now, like I said, I saw here, this guy showed a few weeks ago on the internet, this person drove this car, like I say, about 4,000 miles between L.A. And Vegas back and forth over a period of time. Didn't have to wash the car one time. Showed the car. No bugs on it anywhere. That's bad. Follow me? Only y'all can straighten this out. See? That's what we talking about. Chicago Tribune. Huh? December the 18th. Detroit tops hard-to-tally cities ahead of census. Vacant housing poverty make for a tough count. Now, that's what's going on in Detroit. Okay? You follow me? Because more than likely, a lot of people left there. Because they had to. There's no way to make a living. And a lot of people who were there, they're impoverished. Homeless. See? And that's going on here in Illinois. Because I just read an article, they said it's 160-something thousand people have left Illinois last year. And they had a big exodus the year before that and the year before that. You follow me? See, so people can't make a living. So they moving outside of Chicago, moving outside of Illinois. You understand? Going somewhere else, Indiana, Iowa, down south to Georgia, huh? Going to Florida. And you know there's plenty of problems in them places too. Okay? All right? See, so you understand? But it's hitting the whole earth. You can't run from it. Okay? So it says, when the U.S. Census Bureau starts counting people next year in Detroit, obstacles are bound to arise. The city has tens of thousands of vacant houses, sparse internet access, and high poverty. Factors that will make it the toughest community to tally. Okay? Also, tornadoes kill 4, injure at least 12 in the south. And this is out of Alexandria, Louisiana. Tornadoes down there. See? High winds. Isn't that what? Yeremia 23, Yeremia chapter 30. High wind. They're going to be continual. Okay? Also, the Pope ends pontifical secrecy and clergy sexual abuse cases. They've been keeping that stuff secret, so they saying that is Pope Francis. He bringing out all of the stuff about this sexual abuse that the clergy been committing on the people. At least that's what they claim. Now I'm just gonna read the first paragraph. It said Pope Francis abolished the use of the Vatican's highest level of secrecy in clergy sexual abuse cases Tuesday, responding to mounting criticism that the rule of pontifical secrecy has been used to protect pedophiles, silence victims, and prevent police from investigating crimes. Now, at least they admitting that finally, huh? But I'm going to read the last two paragraphs. Say, also Tuesday, Francis accepted the resignation of the Vatican's ambassador to France, Archbishop Louis Ventura, who is accused of making unwanted sexual advances to young men. Ventura turned 75 last week, the mandatory retirement age for bishops, but that his resignation was announced on the same day as Francis' reforms didn't seem to be a coincidence. Man, now that stuff been going on since day one, okay? Now that's your Christianity, okay? Okay, also France on strike, power cuts, school shut, no Eiffel Tower. Said French union activists cut electricity to nearly 100,000 homes or offices. Eiffel Tower staff walked off the job. Even Paris opera workers joined in Tuesday's nationwide protest across France, singing an aria of anger as workers rallied against the government's plan to raise the retirement age to 64. Despite 13 days of crippling train and subway strikes, French President Emmanuel Macron and his government stayed firm. The prime minister declared his total determination to reshape a pension system that unions celebrate as models for the rest of the world, but that he calls unfair and destined to collapse into debt. Okay? Now, say the retirement reform that has brought them together is just one of their many gripes against Macron, a business-friendly centrist they fear is dismantling France's costly but oft-envied welfare state. And that's all these unions and whatnot. They've been brought together fighting against this, you understand, change in the retirement system. Says several European countries have raised the retirement age or cut pensions in recent years to keep up with lengthening life expectancy and slowing economic growth. Okay, Macron argues that France needs to do the same. Say across the French capital, union leaders demanded that Macron drop the retirement reform. Yeah, but he not doing it. Simple as that. Because again, economic collapse. Okay? You understand? Like I said, soon, you know, it's already coming here. It's already started to a degree, but it's going to get worse here in America. Chicago Tribune, December the 19th. Oh, excuse me, 18th. Navistar to cut 1,300 jobs as orders dry up. Truck maker to follow others in cost-cutting efforts, restructuring. Okay? Because, again, a lot of these businesses, they dropping these orders because, hey, you understand? They can't sustain it economically because business drying up, the dollar drying up, the dollar's being inflated, and it's business drying up, you know? Also, warming world leaves flooded farmers in a bind. Hear that? Warming world leaves flooded farmers in a bind. Okay? Because y'all bringing these floods, these rains, and flooding out, you understand? Out of over here, this is out of Crescent, Iowa. Frogs, carp, and bugs thrived all summer. Now, they mentioned the bugs here, right? Thrived all summer in murky floodwaters where Gene Walter should have planted corn and soybeans. Last year's ruined crops spilled from metal storage bins that burst 9 months ago when the Missouri River surged through two levees near his southwest Iowa farm. So you had bugs over there in Iowa caused the floods, so maybe all the bugs that was in Indiana and other, that's where they went. You follow what I'm saying? I tell you, boy. Chicago Tribune, December the 19th. Soros, George Soros, right? Edomite, right? One of the international bankers, right? Connected to the House of Rothschild. Jab sparked anti-Semitism debate. Said near the end of marathon impeachment hearing in the House of Representatives last month, former White House National Security aide Fiona Hill ties conservative jabs at George Soros to the longest-running anti-Semitic trope that we have in history. Anti-Soros theories amplified by conservatives, are the new protocols of the elders of Zion, Hill told lawmakers, referring to an infamous early 20th century screed that falsely asserts a Jewish conspiracy to control the world. You follow me? Mind control, right? Because that's the protocols are exactly the truth. Okay? Her comment focused fresh attention on the role of Soros' Jewish identity in the right's long-running portrayal of the liberal billionaire as using his wealth to manipulate events for his own benefit. And that's exactly what he's done. That's what they do. Said, indeed, Soros' status as an enemy of the far right predates the Ukraine drama that has brought President Donald Trump to the brink of impeachment. But the 89-year-old Hungarian-born philanthropist, okay, but he's an Edomite, born in Hungary, and financier has played a key part in a narrative woven of unfounded corruption claims that Trump's allies have used to defend him during the impeachment process. I tell you, boy, whew, man, these Edomites with the double reverse psychology, you know, they never stop, always trying to shape and control your mind. You know, like they're not who and what they are. Huh? Tell you, boy, something else. You know? But again, they control these newspapers, and you really can't expect them to do anything else but that. Huh? Because they fighting for their existence, right? These are Malachite illuminated Edomites. They fighting against Yah, so it's a futile task, a futile task, you know what I'm saying? A futile task, you understand? It's totally not going to work, you know? So it's futility, huh? December 20th, Chicago Tribune, ACLU challenges racial inequality as traffic stops spike, okay? And they say as police traffic stops continue to spike in Chicago, the American Civil Liberties Union is asking why minorities are still pulled over much more often than whites, despite court order reforms and city hall searches for its fourth police superintendent in 11 years. Okay? Because we were pulled over a lot more than Caucasian or so-called white drivers, right? So there were roughly 490,000 traffic stops on Chicago streets last year, okay, in 2018, right? And it says more than 200,000 than the previous year, traffic stops, right? According to data from the Illinois Department of Transportation, it was the third consecutive year of sharp increases. About 86% or 421,000 of those stops involved quote-unquote minority motorists. Of those, 300,000 were black. Okay? And the rest evidently were Latino. And more, a lot of them is Israelites too. You follow me? Nah. So they had to stop, you know, stopping us on standing around on corners because that was outlawed. You understand? Unconstitutional. So they started stopping us in vehicles instead. Okay? Now they claim when they do that they find a lot of guns. You understand? But again, you know, Caucasians don't carry guns. Therefore, you're never going to have any equity. It's just not going to happen. Okay? Also, poisonings linked to hard-boiled eggs in bulk. Okay? This is out of New York. Pregnant women, people over the age of 65, and people with weakened immune systems should throw away store-bought hard-boiled eggs because of a food poisoning outbreak linked to a Georgia company. Seven people in five states have been reported ill so far, including someone who died in Texas. Okay, hard-boiled eggs, if you buy them already cooked, but you know, you ain't supposed to be eating eggs anyway, right? chicken eggs or any other unclean bird's eggs, right? Chicago Tribune, December the 20th. Edomite or Israeli woman gets 22 years for investment fraud. A federal judge in Maryland on Thursday sentenced an Israeli or Edomite woman to 22 years in prison for orchestrating a scheme that prosecutors said defrauded tens of thousands of investors across the world out of tens of millions of dollars. That's what Esau does, isn't it? I mean, that's their MO, is it not? Okay. Also, this is from an insurance. Disasters cost world $140 billion. This is out of Berlin. Okay. Insurer Swiss Re says losses from natural and man-made disasters cost about $140 billion this year, down from $176 billion in 2018. Okay. Chicago Sun-Times, December 22nd. Police. Iowa woman said she ran over teen because she thought he was Mexican. And she also, the same woman, she ran over a brother, a little young brother. She saw walking on the sidewalk, just drove up on the corner and hit him with her vehicle. Okay? And this is out of Clive, Iowa. Okay? Tell you, boy. Divisiveness. Huh? Chicago Tribune, December 22nd. Venice finds possible savior in Moses. Tide barriers pass another test, but skeptics remain. Okay? You heard about the flood in Venice, Italy, right? Floated along by barge. One of the 10-ton barriers designed to relieve Venice's perennial flooding looks like a giant plaything, an oversized hinged yellow Lego. Central to the plan to protect the city, some or all of the 78 barriers will one day be raised when the sea rises more than 43 inches to prevent damaging high tides from pushing into the lagoon city. Okay? I tell you, boy, it's... Says, while the concept is simple, its realization has been anything but. Says, the system of movable underwater barriers, dubbed Moses, has been beset by corruption, cost overruns, and delays. Projected at $2 billion and meant to be completed by 2011, the project has so far cost nearly $6.1 billion and is running a decade behind schedule. Okay. They're putting these huge barriers trying to keep that flooding down. Okay. I tell you, boy, not going to work. Not going to work. Also, in France, protests put a lump of coal in holiday travel plans. All right. This is because forget presents. All French people want for Christmas is to be able to get on a train to visit family and friends, but they got strikes, okay? There's that. For they holidays, right? Australia battles fatal wildfires amid catastrophic conditions. I know many of you, if not all of you, saw what's going on in Australia with all of these fires, okay? And going on right now as I speak. And they say many of those animals in those have died. They say there's a preponderance of koala bears that have been burned up. Okay? A whole lot. And we saw a picture here the other day. A koala bear was trying to make it out of the woods. You know, that you know, all the fire was chasing them out of the foliage. I mean, and it was barely moving. Looked like it kind of got burnt. Okay? Also, French forces killed 33 extremists in Mali. You know, this is out of about what the French forces are doing in the Ivory Coast. Okay? You understand? Because they got forces over there in the continent. Again. Okay? You hear what I say? Again. It reminds me of the Berlin Conference, you know, that they had way back there in the 19th century. And, you know, the European nations hacked up the continent of so-called Africa, right? And just took what they wanted to take and divvied it up like gangsters do a map, right? Man. Chicago Tribune, December 23rd. India's leader defends new citizenship law amid protests. Big protests about that citizenship law, okay? You know. But again, all these people in religions, huh? So they got to catch it. Syrian state media, the Edomites, Israelis fired missiles into Syria. Well, they're going to keep on doing that till they stop. And that's till y'all stop them. And like I said, we know how y'all say he going to do that, right? And who he's going to do it through. Also, out of Australia, Prime Minister Scott Morrison apologized Sunday for taking a family vacation in Hawaii as deadly bushfires raged across several states, destroying homes and claiming the lives of two volunteer firefighters. So he cut short his trip, like, I better get back before they want to fire me. Okay. Chicago Tribune, December 23rd. New SNAP rules ignore realities of food insecurity, poverty. Right? I told you they cut and SNAP, Supplemental Nutritional Assistance Program. Okay? And say a sign alerting customers about SNAP food stamps benefits is displayed at a Brooklyn grocery store December the 5th in New York. It says as a child, you know, this writer, Mark Paulus, he said as a child, he often walked a short distance from his family's tenement house in Woonsocket, Rhode Island, to the neighborhood store to buy milk and bread. He paid with food stamps, which my family, he said, needed until we didn't just a few short years later. With four growing boys in the family, we were always running out of milk and bread. Today, I'm the president of a national financing and leasing firm. I worked hard to go from a working poor upbringing to where I am today, but I didn't do it alone. I've been fortunate to have some people guide and lift me up over the years. And when we needed them, my family also had food stamps. See? So he's making the case, you understand, what is the government doing, right? He said, I reflected on all of this in light of recent rule changes to the Supplemental Nutritional Assistance Program, or SNAP, the federal food assistance program that helps lift millions of Americans out of poverty. Come April, come April, more than 688,000 struggling Americans will be at risk of losing their SNAP benefits, formerly known as food stamps, if they can't meet an onerous work requirement. The changes affect able-bodied adults under 50 who don't have children or other dependents. That's 7% of SNAP recipients nationwide. Children, the elderly, people with disabilities, who are the vast majority of SNAP participants, aren't affected. As of April 1st, many of those affected will be limited to 3 months of food aid over a 3-year period unless they're working in job training or volunteering for 80 hours a month. Okay? Now, if they say over 688,000, it might be 6 million. You understand what I'm saying? Okay, but that's what's going on. Okay, and also, almost missed this, fight poverty with renter's tax credit. America has a housing crisis. Since 1960, renters' medium earnings have gone up 5%, while rents have risen more than 60%. Okay. So they, you understand, since 1960, people are earning only 5% more than what they were earning back in 1960, if that. Like I said, back in 1977, I was making $18,000 a year. See, and like I just said, we just saw last week, 44% of American workers make $18,000 or less. 44%, that's almost half, okay? So they saying here, if you're a renter, right, your wages have gone up 5% in the last 60 years, okay, since 1960, right? But the rents have risen 60%. So now how you supposed to keep up with that? You follow me? They say, however, because of inadequate funding, only 1 in 4 eligible households can get rental housing assistance. So that's why you've got a shortage of affordable housing. That's why you got so many people that are homeless. Okay? Chicago Tribune, December 25th. Masses gather to celebrate the birth of JC in Bethlehem. See? And that's the people's problem. And a lot of these people that you see here, you see right there? You know what they are? They're Israelites, so-called Palestinians. Okay? And that's why they, you understand? Why what's happening to them is happening to them. But again, that's why what's happening to the people of the world is happening to them. Because they're in idolatries. All right? Also, let me just read this. It says, Palestinian scouts performed during a parade Tuesday at Manger Square in Bethlehem, right? So while Bethlehem is in the Palestinian-administered area of the Israeli-occupied West Bank, the Edomite separation barrier, the wall, right, encloses parts of the city and is a constant reminder of the complex political reality. Most of the Christmas Eve visitors appeared to be local residents, with foreign pilgrims seeming to make up a modest portion of the crowd. Yeah, because a lot of people not going there because it's problems. You understand what I'm saying? So a lot of visitors, tourists, not going there. All right? Also, Putin says Russia is leading world in hypersonic weapons. Huh? This is out of Moscow. President Vladimir Putin said Tuesday that Russia has got a strong edge in designing new weapons and that it has become the only country in the world to deploy hypersonic weapons. Nice-ass article. Okay, yeah, you understand? America, like I read the article a few, about 20, 30 minutes ago, America's hegemony is declining. Okay, big time. Also, the Israeli army, civilian deaths unexpected in Gaza airstrike. So the Edomites bombed Gaza again, right, and killed civilians, and you know what they say, oh, we didn't know, we sorry, right? But they meant to do it. It's done purposely. You follow me? Chicago Tribune, December 25th. Hair dye straighteners may increase breast cancer risk. For all you women out there that's using hair dyes and straighteners, okay, National Institute of Health Research has found an increased chance of breast cancer among women who regularly use permanent hair dye, particularly African Americans or Israelites. You know, we've talked about that way some years ago. Okay, I talked about that, right? Chicago Tribune, December 26th. Ukraine farmers who face Stalin now fear markets. Okay, Ukraine farmers who face Stalin now fear markets. Most are against Zelensky's plan to put land up for sale. Okay, so I just read earlier where Zelensky has taken this $5.5 billion loan from the IMF, the International Bank and Monetary Fund, right? That, you know, runs through America here, right? He just took a $5.5 billion loan. Now, His plan is to put land up for sale. Well, you know who's going to buy the land? Huh? The Edomites. You follow what I'm saying? And now the farmers is upset because they're not going to be able to buy it. See? Just like Esau bought the land from the farmers here. You know, I talked about that some years ago. You follow me? He came in and paid farmers way more than what the land was actually worth and got the land from the farmers. And now, through his mass production of foodstuffs, you understand, he putting out all this GMO garbage, soybean garbage. You follow me? See? You know, a meat that's been shot up with antibiotics, grown on growth hormones. See, put basically the farmer out of business. Okay? You know? And again, many farmers, he, you know, got into the scamorama ding dong back there in the 60s, 70s, and 80s. They started coming down on them, taking their land. That's what farm aid is all about. You follow me? As I said in the past, Willie Nelson and, you know, these different artists, Whoopi Goldberg, Billy Crystal, you know, I think Robin Williams, they was doing farm aid. But then Esau came down. You understand? It's still going on. I think this farm aid, they do concerts and whatnot. But so many farmers now is out of business and in hot to the government. And this has increased, as we pointed out this last year, right? You understand? With these sanctions and tariffs, now the farmers can't send, you know, grow soybean or corn and send it to China because of the tariffs and the sanctions. And then YAR's hitting them with the floods, as I just read, right? Over in Iowa, you understand? The farmers couldn't do no good because of the floods. That's YAR too. See? And this is all hitting, you understand? That's why when YAR says over in Yeshaya, huh? Talking about the daughter of Babylon, you understand? Is that Yeshaya? I think it's Yeshaya chapter 47, right? He said, they shall not know from whence it rises, because y'all attacking them from every side, he and his daughter Babylon, because he's destroying it as I speak. Hasn't just started, right? And this will go on until he totally destroys the daughter Babylon in one day in its perfection, with the fire, with the nuclear bombs, with them hypersonic missiles and weapons that I just read you, where Putin say they got the lock on. No other country got these hypersonic weapons like Russia got. And Russia and China, huh? And Germany's hooking in with them. Just heard that the other day. You understand what I'm saying? Iran's hooked up with them already. Iran, Russia, and China just did joint military action. You understand? Over there in the east. Just did it here a couple of weeks ago. A week and a half ago. All right? See? So you can see what's happening. And America becoming more and more isolated. And that's the prophecy, is it not? You remember chapter 50 and 51. Okay? Also, Holocaust survivors united from over in the land to Paris to Russia. And that's these Edomites. Okay? Holocaust survivors sang at a Jerusalem's Western Wall, danced in Paris, and lit candles in other cities to celebrate Hanukkah together. See? They ended their Judaism. Okay? Because Hanukkah, again, is in reference to, as we've pointed out in the past, Judas Maccabean, the Hasmonean Edomites in 164 BCE, when they attacked the Syrian Greek force in Jerusalem and ran them out when they thought Antiochus Epiphanes had been killed in that battle with the Romans out in the Mediterranean. See? And that's when they attacked Jerusalem and had control of it for 8 days. That's where you get the Hanukkah story. See, that's what Capers Funai is into. And all these other all these other Israelites who think they Jews and who's into this Hasidism, you follow what I'm saying, that evolved into Judaism, And any other Israelites that, you know, think that Hanukkah has something to do with them. Okay? We've talked about that in the past. You see what Yah's brought through this movement? This is the kind of illumination, that none of these other Israelite groups is talking about, that YAH has not brought that illumination through. And many of them heard it, you understand? And many of them, some of them have adapted to some of this, but they won't acknowledge that they got it through YAH, our righteousness, the arm of YAH. And that's that 53rd chapter of Yeshaya. They esteem this movement not. But again, you know, you understand? That's fulfillment of prophecy, is it not? That's why they hide their faces from it. You understand what I'm saying? Like I didn't say it in the past. You know, when somebody, you understand, this person used to be with this movement, said people scared to call me. And only people scared to call here are people who don't want to deal with the truth. Period. Okay? December 27th, Chicago Tribune. 20 dead in Christmas typhoon in the Philippines. Okay? They over there getting ready to celebrate Christmas in the Philippines, and y'all hit them with a typhoon. You know, celebrate this. Okay? Now, Chicago Tribune, December 29th. Aurora's Cross man retired. Say, this is out of Aurora, a suburb of Chicago, right west of Chicago. Said, ministry honoring more than 27,000 victims of mass shootings place him in national spotlight. So this guy here, he's been driving around the country over the years, putting crosses on people who died from mass shootings, okay, or mass killings. See him there? Now check this out. Says Greg Zanis of Aurora, who has erected crosses for victims of mass shootings across the country, is retiring from the work that has often put him in the national spotlight. He's made more than 27,000 crosses over the years as part of his Crosses for Losses ministry. I always felt this was my calling, he said. He said he believed his work began to show a face of the victims of shootings around America. In the last year, he's acknowledged his ministry became increasingly harder to do. I leave a piece of my heart behind each time I go, he told the Beacon News last spring. I had a breaking point in El Paso, he said, of the August 3rd mass shooting outside of a Walmart store in El Paso, Texas. A gunman shot and killed 22 people and injured 24 others. I hadn't slept for 2 days. It was 106 degrees, and I collapsed from depression when I heard there were two more victims of the mass shooting, he said. A trip earlier this month to the Naval Air Station in Pensacola, Florida, became a turning point, he said. Three people were killed, and eight others were injured in the shootings there. I got as far as Indianapolis and turned back. I decided I wasn't going to do this anymore, he said. His work has also taken a toll on his family. I was trotting around the country, putting 5,000, 6,000 miles on my truck, not even thinking of my family missing me. I did it time and again. I jumped in my truck to go to the Paradise Fire in California without telling anybody, he said. He recalled Orlando, Florida, where a gunman killed 49 people at a nightclub in June 2016. After Orlando, it never stopped, he said, of the mass shootings. The country had me on the road for a while. Every week I have driven 850,000 miles to put up crosses. I slept in my truck. I never had the money to cover what I was doing. Huh? Zanis has relied on his own resources and in recent years on donations. He received a donation of quality wood from a furniture manufacturer to make his crosses. I never made money. I always lost money on a steady basis. At one point last year, I was $10,000 in debt, and somebody covered that for me. Now I am $14,000 in debt. Okay? Now, you got some more here, but you get the drift. He running around putting crosses on mass shooting victims. But you hear what he say? Over 27,000 mass shootings over the years, he's put crosses on. Now, that's America. Okay? Huh? Daughter Babylon. Chicago Tribune, December 29th. Mass killings hit new high in 2019. 41 incidents took place this year, leaving 211 dead. The first one occurred 19 days into the new year when a man used an axe to kill four family members, including his infant daughter. 5 months later, 12 people were killed in a workplace shooting in Virginia. 22 more died at a Walmart in El Paso in August. Okay? See, again, that's that pressure getting to people and the divisiveness, turning people against one another. Want to make, you understand, people falling for the mindset, you know, that's been instilled into them, the propaganda that is some by other person that's the reason for your problem. Now, people have heard me talk about the Edomites. You understand what I'm saying? But as I said in the past, that's the sword. As y'all said, Jeremiah chapter 25, he going to bring on the inhabitants of the earth. That's Yah working through these illuminated Edomites, huh? To drop all of these lies and schemes and scams and drama and wars on the people of the world. But why is this happening, you understand, to the people of the world? Because they're in idolatries. And again, you know, these illuminated Edomites, their forefathers basically made up these idols and images. You understand what I'm saying? So that they could rise to the dominion of the world. Huh? As Yah says over there in, what is it, Zechariah? Chapter 1, he was only a little displeased with Israel, but the heathen has forwarded the affliction. And you know who's the worst of the heathen? Ezekiel chapter 7, right? Yah's brought the worst of the heathen, and they've possessed our land and our, you know, our houses, and say now both these two lands belong to us. Ezekiel chapter 35, and that was the Edomites, the worst of the heathen. Because see, they illuminated the you know, a lot of them, you understand? Not all, I ain't gonna say all of them, but a lot of them. And definitely these Malachi Edomites, and then some of them Temanites too. They illuminated. They know about Yah. They know who they are. They know who Israel really is. But they're not, you understand, they're not gonna come to Yah and submit. You follow what I'm saying? They've been knowing. Their forefathers been knowing. You understand what I'm saying? Because they got a hold of the Book of Remembrance. Back there around, like I say, 331, 330, 329 BCE. That's when they started to become illuminated. And then they became full-blown illuminated sometime after 161 BCE. So, again, they knew what the truth was. But they, you understand, they did everything they could to keep mankind away from the truth. And again, attacking us, as I said earlier in this session again today, right? You understand? Definitely the illuminated Edomite. You understand? You understand these Amalekites and possibly some Temanites with them and maybe some other lines of Esau. But definitely these handful of Amalekite Edomites and however many of those, I don't know. But they definitely understood the way of the Most High and know the truth. But they've done everything they can to keep Israel cut off from getting it. That's why they moved all of the businesses out of here. 1970 coming up. And said, make brick without straw. Pay your rent. Huh? But I'm not going to give you a job. Huh? I'm going to lock you up. Again, Yeshua chapter 42, right? Many Israelites, definitely these, you understand, since 1970 is hid in prison houses. Isn't that right? Over 2 million. And most of them is Israelites, so-called African-American Latinos. Many of these Latinos are Israelites, don't know it. Now, see, all this is orchestrated. But again, this is happening. Why? Because they got their crosses around their neck. They got their crosses in their heart. They got their, you understand, moon and, what is that, quarter moon and sickle in their heart. You know, Islam. You understand what I mean? They in idolatry. They in Judaism. Huh? They're in Christianity, they're in Islam, they're in Buddhism, Hinduism, whatever. You know, they're in religions. That's why this is happening to the people of the world, let alone Israel. See? And Illuminated Edomite knows this. His whole thing is to keep us away from Yah. To do, he's doing anything and everything he could and can to keep us away from Yah. You understand? Even to the point where I know he supports some of these Israelite movements that's in the idolatry, some shape, form, or fashion, that ain't really about, that ain't totally committed to Yah, and it's only one movement that's totally committed and submitted to Yah. And you looking at the name of it, over my shoulder. Yah Our Righteous. That's the only movement that's totally committed and submitted to Yah. Because any other Israelite out there that truly understand, they going to come into Yah Our Righteousness too. Because that's the arm of Yah. That's the movement of Yah. Again, you read me chapter 23. Huh? And that's what Jerusalem's going to be called when Yah humbles these elite and they come and get his movement to take it back. It goes to Jerusalem, and soon after that, not long after that, Jerusalem's going to be called Yah Our Righteousness. Up until after the last battle. Huh? Ezekiel chapter 48. And after the last battle, when the dust settled, then Jerusalem will be called Yah Is There. He who creates is there forever. Because that even before that, he'll be dwelling in his temple in the midst of the children of Israel, the King, Yah of Hosts. You understand? So again, mass killings hit new high last year. Huh? Also, truck bombing killed 79 in Somalia. That's over there in Somalia. It's stuff everywhere. Huh? Also, thousands of koala bears, which is what I just got through talking about, right? Thousands of koala bears feared dead in Australia wildfires. Okay? They say the mid-northern coast of New South Wales was home to up to 28,000 koalas. But wildfires have significantly reduced the population in recent months. They say up to 30% of the habitat of the koala bear has been destroyed. So they just don't know how many koala bears have died in these fires. And you know the koala bears is connected to other things. You know what I'm saying? That's how everything is set up. Chicago Tribune, December 29th, sharp increase seen in processed meat recalls. Okay, processed meats. Besides glass, consumers finding metal and plastic in processed meats. Okay, this is out of Washington. Bits of metal, hard plastic, rubber, and even glass are increasingly getting mixed and baked into processed meat products reaching consumers, triggering a record number of safety recalls. Okay, so far this year, the Agriculture Department has announced 34 recalls involving 17 million pounds of meat products after stray materials were found in them. Okay, say metal parts are breaking off machines that mix, chop, and puree ingredients. Plant workers' rubber gloves are falling into the meat mixes, and bits of plastic and glass from meat packaging and ingredient containers are getting ground into the food. The makers of some of the most beloved and recognizable ready-made food staples have issued the recalls, including Tyson Foods, chicken tenders, Jimmy Dean's, sausages, and Spam. Okay? And again, because the people, you understand, the people are disillusioned. You know, the morale is shot. You follow me? Because they going to work, can't hardly make a living, all kind of problems at home. You understand what I'm saying? All kind of problems in their life, can't pay their bills, they still working overtime, having problems. And so they don't care. So they don't care, you know, I don't care. You know, plastic glove fall into the grinding machine, piece of metal or some glass, I don't care, so what? You know? Chicago Tribune, December 29th, Pennsylvania diocese paid $84 million to 564 victims of abuse. Now that's just the Pennsylvania diocese. Paid $84 million to 564 victims of abuse. Now, you know what more likely where they got that money, huh? From people who go there dropping money in the plate to their idol. Or should I say to their idols, right? You follow me? Why they abusing their children. And many of them who dropping money there got abused when they was a child and still ain't figured it out, okay? At least 490 protesters killed since October. This is out of Iraq. Oh, they got big protests over in Iraq against the United States. I don't know if you heard, probably many of you did, yesterday, you understand, the Iraqis attacked the American embassy in Iraq. Okay? And Trump government sent troops to Iraq to try to protect the embassy, because that's supposed to be the biggest embassy America got in the world, there in Iraq. And you know why, right? Because of the oil that's there. You follow me? Also, thousands in Paris protest pension reform plan. Thousands of protesters opposed to the French government's plan to revamp the retirement system marched through Paris on Saturday, the 24th day of crippling strikes. See? And it's not going to change anything. It's not going to change a thing. Okay? Because this is it. The collapse of the fiat currency. And this is the collapse of the system of Esau and the systems of man. It's never going to recover. It's just going to get worse and worse. and Yah's salvation, not only for Israel, but for all mankind, that turns and submits to him with all their heart and all their soul, and get in compliance with their creator, Yahweh's laws, statutes, ordinances, judgments, commandments, and precepts. It's just that simple, not complicated. Chicago Sun-Times, December 30th, $5 million bill after five stabbed at Hanukkah celebration. So they there worshiping their idol, the Edomites, out of Muncie, New York, and this Thomas Grafton went up in there and stabbed a bunch of them. And again, he did a stint in the Marines. Now, they come back and said he got, you understand, he didn't really do no big stint in the Marines, but he was in the Marines for a little while. All right, because I read some of these articles, you understand, and said that, you follow me, he was all right when he was a teenager in high school and whatnot, but when he went to the Marines, he was only in there for a little while, and then they like, you know, let him go out. So is that when they shot him up with whatever they shot him up with? And he said he's been a schizophrenic ever since. Now, that's what I'm reading. That's what I see. He went to the Marines for a big come on back. He a Manchurian candidate. You follow what I'm saying? So they done pushed his button, and had him go up there with them Edomites so that they can do what? Start trying to impugn Hebrew Israelite movements, which is really aimed at this movement. It ain't aimed at them other movements, because they ain't worried about them. They know them other Israelite movements is off. They know that Yah's not with them, because they not with Yah. You understand what I'm saying? So, and like I just said a minute ago, and I said this in the past, I know Esau is funding to whatever degree some of these Israelite movements that are in idolatries, whatever shape, form, or fashion, that's not about Yah, because there is only one movement that's about Yah, and that's this one, right here. I'm saying this one. Y'all right. It's the only movement that's totally committed to Yahweh. Simple as that. Doing what Yah said to do. And again, for all of you out there that Israelites, that's in other Israelite movement, that's got a problem with that, I direct you to Yeshaya chapter 50. And after you read that, then I direct you to Yeremia chapter 23. And after you read that, I direct you to Yeremia chapter 33. And remember that the illuminated Edomite between the 4th and 9th century CEAD took the name of Yah, somewhere between there, took the name of Yah out of this book of remembrance in over 6,800 places. And so as I say that, just go back there and read that Yeremia chapter 23 and chapter 33. And see what the movement of Yah is to be called and what Jerusalem is to be called. And like I said, when you do all that again, go back to Yeshaya chapter 50 and read that. Okay? December 30th, Chicago Sun-Times, right? Texas congregants kill church gunman. You might have heard about that, This guy went up into this church, and we saw it on the news and on the internet, right? And he came in there with a fake beard and whatnot and upped a shotgun. Killed an Israelite, killed a Caucasian, and then Caucasian security guard that was in the church with their pistols jumped up and shot and killed him. Because we saw matter of fact, we saw the security that was dressed regular but had his gun on him, who actually killed him, because he was talking about it. I think he's like 60-something years old, about 62 himself. He killed the guy. Young guy, young Caucasian guy. His name was Thomas Kinnanen. Okay, Kinnanen is his name. Here he is right here. Right there. That's him. Okay? And he had on a fake beard, and the security guy said he saw him. He said he looked funny, he had his eye on him. And when he upped that shotgun and then killed the Israelite guy that was standing there next to him and killed a Caucasian, he upped his pistol and shot and killed him dead. You know, and if you can make it out, you can see it right there. There's the security guard right here. That's him there. And that's Kinnanen right there. Okay? So, you know, I tell you, boy, this thing is crazy. But again, where was JC? They up in the church, just like these people in the synagogue. Just like these people, you understand, Edomites, you understand, in the synagogue or doing Hanukkah, or these people in the church, as we said before, where they idol? You know, the Edomites worship Hashem, whoever, whatever that is. How come Hashem didn't protect them? Huh? Those who's up in the church house worshiping JC, Christianity. How come JC didn't protect them? I'm going to do the same thing Elia did in 1 Kings chapter 18. I guess Hashem and JC, huh? And at these mosques, when they jump up and kill somebody, and these Muslims drop a bomb on them. Esau drop bombs on them over there in the East. You know, America drop bombs on them. You understand, on the Muslims and kill them. I guess Allah, Jesus, and Hashem is all off, you know, drinking Mai Tais somewhere in the Caribbean or something together. Huh? Yeah, I'm gonna mock them. Cause how come they idols is not protecting them? But see, they idols is just that, idols. Got eyes and see not, ears and hear not, mouth and nothing coming out of it. Huh? They got hands, but they handle not. They got feet, but they walk not. Cause they idols. And those who worship them are just like unto them. Isn't that what it say? Isn't that what Yah say in his word? Okay? See? And then they got down here about this Grafton Thomas, huh? Man charged in Hanukkah attack, not clear at all in court. Because he a Manchurian candidate. You follow what I'm saying? They pushed his button, sent him in on the Edomites, and he don't even know what's happening. You follow what I'm saying? Okay? But they done charged him with hate crime. His family said, you know, he's a schizo. He's schizophrenic. And what I'm reading, you understand, he didn't become that till after he had did that little stint with the Marines. Now, okay, say Thomas served in the Marines and was president of his class at a high school in Queens. He attended William Patterson University between 2005 and 2007. The university confirmed where he played football as a walk-on running back. Thomas' family said his mental health deteriorated over the years. You hear that? He would hear voices and have trouble completing sentences at times. That's the lawyer for the family, for him. You understand what I'm saying? You follow me? And his high school coach said when he was playing football at high school, when he was going to high school, he said he was fine. He said, I'm going to read what his high school coach said. His high school coach name was... let me see. Is it in this one? Or is it in this? No. It must be this one. Because I just read it today. Matter of fact, it must be this, what I got here. So I got to get to that. Okay, but I get to it in a minute. Okay, also, in this December 31st, this Guido, who was, you know, Esau, America, was trying to supplant Maduro with over there in Venezuela. Check this out. Guaido's buzz fades as Maduro holds firm. Okay? Despite U.S. support, opposition leader lost ground in 2019. So this Guaido, you understand? They trying to supplant Maduro with this Guaido, and it hasn't worked. Huh? It hasn't worked. You follow me? Because the Venezuelan people, you understand? The majority of them, about 60-something, 70%, they solidly locked behind Maduro. And the army is solidly locked behind Maduro. Because that's, you understand, that's what the Illuminated Edomite always goes after, the army that supports, you understand, whoever is the president. Huh? Because they evidently got to Evo Morales' army. And so Morales, you know, the army came down on him. He had to lead. It was Yah that just didn't have him killed. You understand? And America been doing this for years. Years. Like I said earlier in this session, they started with, you understand, you can say millennia, because they started with Ptolemy, one of the generals of Alexander, right? Now you fast forward up into the 20th century, right? They did it, you understand? They knocked off Mossadegh in Iran back there in 53 and got, you understand, the military to go against him, and they cooled him. Then, you understand, they got Arbenz, you understand, back there in the 50s in Guatemala and got the military to coup him, huh? They got Lumumba, you understand, in the Congo, huh? In the early 60s. Got what's his name? Mobutu, who was head of the army in the Congo to knock, you know, to undermine Lumumba. And they got Lumumba and had him totally dismembered. I talked about that in the past, where you couldn't even, people don't even know where his grave was. He didn't have no grave. You follow me? That's how much they hated Lumumba, because he, you know, these people, Mossadegh, Arbenz, Lumumba, they nationalized. Evo Morales nationalized. You know, they said they're going to use the natural resources of their country to aid and abet their people, not these corporate, you understand, these corporate fascists, you understand, these corporate owners who own these huge corporations, illuminated Edomite corporations that all hooked in the Rothschild, you understand what I'm saying? You know, the Warburgs, the Schiffs. And that's the reality of this thing. Huh? They couped Allende in 73 in Chile with Pinochet, who was head of the army. See, that's what they do. They come in there and offer the army, huh? The generals or whatever, you understand, try to get the army to unseat the president who's trying to aid and abet his people. So they get these sellouts. See, because again, it's been brought to me, it very well could be, you understand, you had some sellouts around this movement. I know you didn't have some agents, as we've mentioned in the past. You follow me? You understand, some of on the payroll, they didn't sit around this movement to try to, you understand, you pull the movement away, you understand, from Yah, okay, and take it off in some perverse, you know, direction. See, but Yah, you going against Yah, so you know, he purged you out according to your heart. Again, when Yah said, tells us over there in Yeshua chapter 54, no weapon formed is going to be able to hurt his servant, his movement, his servants. Huh? No weapon formed going to be able to hurt his movement, because you're going up against Yah. You think you're going up against me or, you understand, others of the movement, but you're going up against Yah's host. Huh? Yeshua chapter 27, when he says he going to watch over, huh? He going to watch over the vineyard of red wine, which is the same as the fruitful field, the fruitful forest that's out there in the wilderness. He going to watch over the vineyard of red wine, what? Night and day, lest any heard it. That he's going to humble the Leviathan too, which is humbling the Leviathan, huh? This illuminated Edomite, you understand? Any of them, this house of Rothschild, any of them, to him, to Yah. They got to humble themselves before Yah. Because again, he done said he's going to do that. Because they're going to cause Jerusalem movement to take root. That's Yeshua chapter 27, huh? The vineyard of red wine. Follow me? The fruitful field out here in the forest. Or should I say out in the wilderness, right? The fruitful forest, the fruitful field out in the wilderness, right? See, this is, again, like according to the coming out of Egypt. Like I said in the past, Amenophis II, he was talking all tough. Huh? You understand? Until Yah humbled him. Yah's in the process of humbling this illuminated Edomite and these monarchies, huh? And these people of stature that know that's adversarial to his will initially, huh? He's in the process of humbling them all. Because you're dealing with Yah of hosts, he who creates. Okay? You know? But they can't figure it out, huh? So Guido, he. Guaido, he done fizzed out. Huh? Because Maduro and the Venezuelan people and the Venezuelan army understand. If they leave, if they go over, sell out, and go over to this international banking, huh? You understand? This United States of America that represents the Illuminati Edomite, this international banker, the IMF, huh? The World Bank, the BIS, they just sold themselves out. They just relegated themselves to nothing because Illuminated Edomite, he doesn't have anything for sellouts. And eventually he going to get rid of you because he know if you sell out your own people, you'll sell him out. So eventually you might sell out to him for a while. He try to act like, you know, he give you a little something, but eventually he going to knock you out of the box too. Like all turncoats, like all sellouts. You know, those who sell out, those who they sell out to, don't have anything for them. Right? Now check this out. Trump ally may have broken Venezuela sanctions, U.S. office officials say. Huh? Now, you see who down there at the bottom of that? Eric Prince. Talked about him in the past, right? He the one that set up Blackwater, the biggest, most potent mercenary group, from what we can see, in the world. Blackwater. You know, they started calling themselves by different names, you know, but they still call Blackwater. Check this out. This is out of Miami. Eric Prince, a major Republican donor and founder of controversial security firm Blackwater, has been referred to the U.S. Treasury Department for possible sanctions violations tied to his recent trip to Venezuela for a meeting with a top aide of President Nicolas Maduro, two senior U.S. officials said. So, see, now, again, Eric Prince, more than likely an Edomite, okay, but he claims to be Christian crusader. As we said in the past, that's what he claimed, right? Now he went over there. They gave him. They trying to act like he violated security. You understand? U.S. to go over there to Venezuela, but they knew he was going. You understand? Now he went over there to talk to one of Maduro's top aides. So now is he trying to? You understand? Pull Maduro's top aide over? Maybe not outright, but you understand? Trying to pull him over to them so that they can oust Maduro, what I just got through talking about. That's what it looks like to me, because Eric Prince ain't about nothing. Simple as that. His sister is Betty DeVos, or DeVos, however you want to pronounce it. You understand? Who Trump appointed over the, we didn't say, brought that out before, who Trump appointed over the education situation. You follow me? See how they all inseminated into Trump's cabinet and hooked up with Trump? How he against the deep state? Because Eric Prince been hooked up with all these presidents, you understand? Obama, you understand? Bush, huh? You follow me? Clinton, you dig? Old man Bush, you know? So how is Trump against the deep state? So they're going to try to claim they didn't know he might be under violation. See if anything, if they do anything to Eric Prince. He over there trying to pull, like I say, trying to pull a coup right now on Maduro. Trying to see if he can get some sellouts. Okay? Chicago Tribune, January 1st. Shiite militia attacks U.S. Embassy in Iraq. Okay? And many of you who heard about this, you probably heard what America, they immediately want to blame Iran. It's Iran behind it. Iran, Iran, Iran. See, again, you know, divide and conquer, and also, you know, diversion. You know what I'm saying? Because they know Iran is hip to them. You know? Simple as that. See, they can't pull no game on Iran. Iran hip to them. And been hip to them. Like I said in the past, if you actually talk to some of them Iranians, officials over there, that Khomeini and different one, they probably tell you, well, them is Edomites. Them ain't Israelites. Okay? That's why, again, we getting censored, propagandized news. Again, Jeremiah 8, verse 17. You know, the serpents and cockatrice spewing out venom, poison. Okay? Okay, and so here, January 1st. Chicago Tribune, Australia sees worst wildfire season. Residents trapped, homes destroyed, 12 confirmed dead. Okay, and Australia, the bushfire. Yeah, dropping drama across the earth and all these nations that are iniquitous, wicked, idolatrous, and the people thereof. And Yah is salvation, and only Yah is salvation. He alone, there is no other. So now, all you prideful, egotistical, huh, arrogant people out there, when you hear this, wherever you are on the face of the earth, turn toward Yah with all your heart and all your soul. Submit and obey. Yah is greatly merciful. Huh? Ezekiel chapter 18. Huh? Your iniquities and wickedness will not be brought to you if you turn and submit and obey to Yah of hosts with all your heart and soul. Huh? Because again, those of you out there that didn't know anything about Yah, your creator, Yah is greatly merciful. Seek Yah while he can be found, while he is near. Okay? Also, you understand, this gunman grew angry in the past. This Keith Thomas Kinnunen, that shotgunned the Israelite and the Caucasian up in the church I just talked about, and before the security guy killed him. Now, they say he was angry, because he had come to the church in the past asking for some cash, some money, and the church wouldn't give it to him. Said the man who fatally shot two people at a Texas church was ruled mentally incompetent to stand trial in 2012 and was repeatedly fed by the congregation, but got angry when church officials refused to give him money. So he come up in there in the beard of the disguise, pulled out his shotgun with the shoot, but killed him dead, see? Because this is his police mugshot right there. Okay, that's his police mugshot. Okay, that's him. All right. And also, judge orders Alex Jones to pay $100,000 for what he said Sandy Hook didn't happen up there in Connecticut. So he going to court. So Alex Jones was said that he got to pay $100,000 in attorney's fee. So quite naturally, his lawyer, you know, him and his lawyer, they are, fighting it on appeal. But Alex Jones said he's ordered to pay $100,000. Okay. But also, this is the article that I was talking about this Grafton Thomas, right? Marines. Hanukkah stabbing suspect was kicked out of basic. The man charged with stabbing five people during a Hanukkah celebration in New York began boot camp to enter the U.S. Marine Corps, but was separated from the service a month later for fraudulent enlistment. So they say. The Marine Corps, right? Check this out. Marine Corps spokeswoman would not provide details on why Grafton Thomas left the Marines as a recruit in late 2002, about a month after he started training. You hear that? Now, that's what they claim. Now, they just said fraudulent enlistment in the paragraph above that. Now, the paragraph under that, they say she would not disclose, You follow me? She wouldn't provide detail of why he was put out. Now, okay? Those specifics are administrative in nature and therefore information we are required to keep private. So that must mean they ain't got their story straight yet. Okay? Before they say anything, they don't want to make any mistakes. But they just made one, right? I just cited you. They said fraudulent enlistment. Then they come back and say, well, we can't disclose anything. Make up your mind. Now, again, when you read through this, right, I tell you, boy, now check this out. I'm going to read this, you understand, about him, like I said earlier, you understand, what his ex-coach in high school, what he wrote. Now, it says, his former coach at William Patterson, Mike Miller, said Thomas was injured early on and wasn't around long enough to get to know him. This is in college, right? Because it says, let me just go back a little bit more. Okay, military law defines fraudulent enlistment as a knowingly false representation or deliberate concealment as to a recruit's qualifications. That could involve a recruit failing to disclose certain medical conditions, past drug use, or an arrest record, including cases that are sealed because the recruit was a juvenile or for other reasons. Okay? So again, when they gave him the Manchurian candidate drug to turn him into a Manchurian candidate, he probably didn't act like they wanted him to act, You understand? That's what I'm saying. Now, check this out. Thomas had multiple run-ins with law enforcement before he was taken into custody over the weekend, okay? Because he's been schizo, evidently, ever since the Marine situation, all right? Says, including an arrest for assaulting a police horse. Not the policeman, but the horse, okay? According to an official briefed on the investigation who was not authorized to discuss the matter publicly and spoke to the AP on condition of anonymity. Details related to that case appear to be under seal. Sussman, which is the attorney for the family, right? And for him, right? I guess that the family provided this. His name is Michael Sussman, so he an Edomite, right? The attorney for him that his family got. The Sussman said to the AP, he emailed to the AP Tuesday that Thomas was recruited and suffered a wrist injury during basic training. So he had a wrist injury. Come on, be for real. I know that didn't put him out of basic training. Huh? Now check this out. He was then released from that training, Sussman said. That is the best information we have at this time. So they put him out of basic training for the Marines because he had a wrist injury? Come on. Thomas' family has said his mental health deteriorated over the years and that he has been hospitalized on multiple occasions. After washing out of the Marines, Thomas attended William Patterson University in New Jersey between 05 and 07, and he played football as a running back while there. All right. His former coach at William Patterson, Mike Mello, said Thomas was injured early on and wasn't around long enough to get to know him. Because now he's been shot up with this stuff, whatever they put on him in the Marine training. That's what I'm saying. All right. Now, check this out. When he was still in high school, now this is before he went to the Marines. Now I'm getting ready to read. Now, check this out. When he was still in high school, Thomas was arrested in Brooklyn after police found him with a gun, recalled Joseph Burton, then his coach on a neighborhood football team. Thomas had been heading home from practice with friends when they came across a gun and picked it up with the intention of turning it in to the authorities for buyback money, Burton said. Thomas was arrested with it on his way home, said Burton, who went to court and wrote a letter to support Thomas in the case. Sussman confirmed the arrest in an email to the AP saying the firearm had been found in a park. The case ultimately was closed without punishment, Burton added, with the judge giving Thomas a chance to go through with his plans to graduate from high school and enter the military. Sussman said the case was dismissed. All right. So that's no biggie, right? Now check this out. And Thomas is all right when he's in high school. Check this out. Thomas, in the meantime, went on to play fullback, nose tackle, and defensive end for the team, which won a 2000 championship in a local league. At the time, he was a joy-loving, fun-loving kid, a typical adolescent boy who didn't seem troubled, Burton recalled. We had a lot of interaction with each other, and it was all good, Burton said. Nothing like the trouble he has now. So, before he went into the Marine, he was all right. But he went into there, didn't stay long, because again, they're not letting him out of any Marines because of a wrist injury. Give me a break. You understand? See, they did something to him when he was in there, and he wasn't acting like they wanted, and so they let him go. But more likely than not, he was acting just like they wanted. They done turned him into a Manchurian candidate, done sent him back out here, and when they pushed his button, he went in there into the Edomite's house. Now, because when they ready to use him, huh, to try to rev up this anti-Semitic mess, you understand, a so-called black Hebrew Israelites hate Jews, hate, you understand, Israelis, you understand, anti-Semitic. See, that's all game. All right, for your righteousness, your Jerusalem and the Holy See, the Q&A to follow.